Welcome back to Ozarks Fox AM. Look who's here after a week being gone. It's the Luz, Chris Luzader.
Hello, Luz.
Did you miss me?
Yes, we did.
Okay, good.
Did you miss us?
Yeah.
I doubt
it.
Oh,
I don't think
so. Well, I was jet setting.
You were in Arizona.
Yes, I was.
Warm.
It was dry and warm and sunny. All the things I love. And my allergies weren't bothering me.
Oh, good
They're
for you.
So bad right now.
So how was Arizona?
It was so lovely. It was so lovely.
Good?
So there's something I do want to tell you real quickly. There are two new movies on screens.
Okay.
What Men Want, which stars Taraji P. Henson. I love her. And it's sort of like flipping the script on that Mel Gibson movie from a while back where he was like, what women want.
Yes. Exactly.
So, I loved that
and
movie.
I did too.
I love that movie. Amazing.
I mean, he waxed his leg and everything. And then the Lego Movie 2, which is the second part.
Did you like Lego Movie 1?
Yeah, they're very well done.
I never saw it.
Chris Pratt, I didn't see it either.
Chris Pratt's a great vocal styling, so those are fun movies.
Okay.
So, and I'll get to award season in just a second because I have a cool short video
I want to show you.
But, so while I'm on trips, I like to do this thing where, when I'm out of town, I like to check out movies that have been filmed. You know, what movies have been filmed in the area.
Oh,
so I was in the Mesa Phoenix area, and lots of great movies were filmed there. So Vegas Vacation, Wayne's World, Bill and Ted's Excellent Adventure. Then Phoenix is close, so I went over there, and lots of great movies have been filmed there as well, like Days of Thunder.
Ooh.
I love me some Tom Cruise.
Yep.
Jerry Maguire was filmed.
One of your favorites.
Some scenes
there. And of course, a very major fan favorite, which is called the Nicolas Cage movie. Do you know what I'm talking
about? Are you
about
Raising Arizona?
Yes.
Oh, yes. Yes.
And the whole opening sequence of Psycho was filmed there.
Really?
So I do have some photos to toss up.
Okay, let's see the photos.
That we can rush through a little bit.
Yes.
So, that's me trying to be a photographer just because
that's
I love all cacti. Yeah. I love cactus. So that was in Mesa.
Gorgeous.
Nothing very exciting about it. There's a little place called the Orange Patch. We can roll through that. I just thought I was real cute. I wanted to bring some sunshine back. So there's that. There's me and some orange. I'm a sucker for palm trees. Okay?
I love them.
Love palm trees. And that's me with my Fast and Furious car.
Oh, did you rent that?
Yeah. Well, it was my rental car. But
are you kidding me?
How cool do
I
look?
I've never seen such a cool rental
car. That's just me looking cool.
You're
okay.
So cool.
Yeah, and that's just me also looking cool in downtown Mesa area. The theme is, I'm looking cool.
I get you.
Me that's and good. Humpty Dumpty.
That looks like the one we had on the square. Remember our art?
Yeah.
Yes, that's so
me
great.
Me and Humpty Dumpty. Me thinking I'm in Jurassic Park, apparently. And, okay, so it got real dark. But it used to be called Phoenix International Speedway. Mm-hmm. That's where Days of Thunder had some scenes filmed. But I was doing my best and putting my cool car lights on me to try to get some light.
Oh, what happened? That was the best I could do.
Okay, so this is Camelback Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Now, what I should have done is what Nicolas Cage and his pal did by sitting in some loungers in front of the mountain.
Mm-hmm.
But no, I decided to hike it.
Really?
There I am at the top of it. So I'm smiling there, but that's probably after a small panic attack
that I may have had going to the top.
And that's me looking like, am I going to fall to my death?
How high is that?
It's high.
It's scary.
And then there was a sign. I should have shown you a picture of the sign that said, this is an extremely difficult hike.
Wow.
That Chris Luzader has no business going up this mountain.
Did you do this by yourself?
No, I had a friend with me.
Okay,
but I'm proud of you. That's amazing.
It was rigorous. So this is where all the opening sequence of Psycho was shot. And sorry, it was getting a little dusky. But Central Street and Monroe Street at downtown Phoenix, and that was like back in 1959, 1960. They have a couple of gold stars out in front of this hotel. That's Humphrey Bogart's star. And I think they have one of Clark Gable.
Oh,
or maybe
nice.
I reversed them.
I can't read it.
Who's
so
your favorite
good.
Old star?
My favorite old star? Probably Bogey.
Bogey?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Love that.
And that is, it was like she was doing, you know, she'd absconded with this money in Psycho, and then she was going to all these different locations. Mm-hmm. So that is the, is that the security building?
Yes, it
yep,
is.
Security building. It still stands today. And that's the trust building, which is now some lofts.
But it's beautiful.
Right? Yeah, beautiful. It's really mm-hmm. neat. And then there's a, I'm hoping the next one's this cool hotel. But if it's not, then we'll roll with it.
Oh, they don't have it. That's all
okay.
They got.
Okay. Okay. But there's the Hotel San Carlo, which you can Google. It still stands. It's a boutique hotel. It's amazing.
Looks like you had a great mm-hmm. time.
Yeah,
I love
it was
that.
Fun. It just, I like to see what was filmed and stuff. And so. Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. And I know you also have a video. What is that?
Yes, yeah. I do. So award season is still on. The Oscars are February 24th. Uh-huh. And I wanted to show everyone where the very first Oscars happened. So roll it.
Love celebrating them even more, and I especially love doing that right here on Hollywood Boulevard inside the historic Roosevelt Hotel. And right here in this space is where the very first Academy Awards took place, May 16th, 1929. It celebrated the movies from 1927 and 28. It cost $5 to get in this space. 270 people were in this room. The ceremony was 15 minutes. A little bit different than what happens at the Dolby Theater for hours and hours, Oscar night nowadays, with all the red carpet and all that hoopla. But, you know, whatever celebrates the movies, it's fun. Happy Oscars.
That's great seeing that.
15 minutes. Can you imagine an Oscar ceremony being 15 minutes?
No. I would love that, actually.
No.
Well, can we split it down to maybe 45 minutes?
No, a couple hours. Oh. But we don't have to have a bunch of hoopla.
But don't you think it is too long, though, right now?
I love the Screen Actors Guild because mm-hmm. it's a concise 2 hours. Critics' Choice is three because they add TV. That's not my problem that they add the TV.
You know,
but maybe, maybe a three?
Three. People's attention spans are so short. I think an hour and a half is good.
Oh.
I say 2 hours.
It depends.
8 to 10 central.
It
8
depends.
To 10 central.
Yeah, with no intermission.
But I'll be back next week. I have some behind the scenes that we're putting together from the Critics' Choice Awards. Because I showed you some slick stuff.
Yes.
We're going to do some behind the scenes. And then the next week will be right before the Oscars, so I'm working on my predictions.
Can I ask you a quick question about movies and award season?
Let me see if I know anything about movies.
Yes.
Okay, go.
Is it true? Because I've seen a lot of trailers coming out for movies that to me look like what you would think is award quality type movies.
Mm-hmm.
However, I have heard rumors that studios release movies in January and February that they don't particularly like and that could be considered for award ceremonies. Is that true?
Usually, if something comes out in January or February, it wasn't quite good enough. However, if you'll recall, one of the greatest movies, my favorite movie of all time, Silence of the Lambs, came out in February 14th, actually, of 1991.
Really?
And it won everything.
Did they not expect that?
I do not know what the reasoning was behind that.
This is the first I've heard about that.
Mm-hmm. So
that's what I always heard, because I've seen some, I can't even remember the movies off the top of my head, but I'm like, these have great actors, they look amazing, like, why wasn't this saved till next November, December?
Then as limited releases are making their way to other cities, then people are in theaters, maybe those are sold out, and then there's still good pickings. So
the good ones are released November, December?
Well, typically for award
season. October to December.
I got you.
Yeah. Okay. That they really want to push.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We appreciate you. And
I know a lot about nothing.
Thanks for bringing some sunshine back to us.
Yes.
I bet you wanted to stay longer.
Yes, I did.
All right. Well, we'll see you again next week.
See you next Friday. You can't leave again.
Okay. All right,
we're not letting her.
So much more fun coming up on Ozarks Fox AM when we come back. Don't go anywhere. We're going to be right here.
What are the popular films right now, though? What's getting the last minute push for us?